Hi, this is Tamara from Mooglyblog.com, and in this video, I'm taking a closer look at Patons Norse, which is a gorgeous, premium-look yarn from Yarnspirations. It comes in about 10 beautiful heathered-look colorways, and it has this really great, almost felted look to it because of a unique construction. Let's take a closer look at the fiber itself. Here in this ball, which you can see they come in balls, not in skeins, it has this really gorgeous, that you can see that heathered look. It just changes colors a little bit right in there. And that's due partially, at least, to the construction. And here you can see a close-up of the yarn itself. The way this yarn is made is that the fiber is blown into a core. It's not plied or wound. It's actually blown in. That's what gives us this really gorgeous felted look to it, rather than being wound or plied. Now, as you can see, Patons Norse actually comes with two labels wound around the ball. Both of them have important information. The smaller label, if I can turn it over here, has the care instructions. It is machine washable, but I would probably recommend hand washing it just to be a little safe. It is a premium look yarn. It's a little different construction. You can try, like I say, you can try washing it in the washing machine on cold water, but I really like the idea of hand washing this one because you'll want to reblock it a little bit if you've made a garment with it, most likely. You do not want to dry clean it, but you can tumble dry it at low heat. On this label right here, you can see we've got the actual name of the yarn. It is 3.5 ounces or 100 grams per ball, and that translates to 211 yards or 193 meters. And here we have the fiber content itself. This yarn is 53% acrylic, 28% wool, and 18% polyester. And it is does have a wool bit of a wool feel to it too. Now up here on top of this label, you can see it is a super bulky weight. You can kind of see that comes for a lot from the halo and the fuzziness that's around the strand of the yarn itself. As for recommended hook and needle sizes, it recommends an 8mm or US 11 set of needles or an 8mm US L 11 crochet hook. If we take a little bit more of a look here at the label, once it's torn off, there we are. You can see here is another copy of those machine wash and dry instructions. So if you need to, you can keep just this one label. But the other one will have some fun pattern information on it too. So here I have a USL 8mm hook, the recommended hook size, and I've worked up a bit of a crochet swatch in the Patons Norse. It has a really beautiful drape, a really gorgeous look to it with any of the stitches I tried. I did find that the yarn likes to stick to itself. You can see all that halo. It does like to stick to itself a little bit. So you want to make sure you have a nice slick hook or needles when you are working with it. That stickiness, that texture does make it just a little bit harder to frog, but I didn't have any major problems. I have finished a sweater in it, and I did a fair bit of frogging, and as long as you take your time, it does frog pretty well. So I'll go ahead and finish that stitch, and then we can go ahead and pull out a couple here. So you can see, you just want to go ahead and take your time with it, and you can frog your work with it. I didn't have any splitting, especially with that construction. I don't know if that would ever be an issue. But of course, I used my clover hook here, which has a little bit more of a rounded tip too. I did go through several balls of both of these shades of gray while making the sweater, and I found the colors to be very consistent. But if we look at the label here, you will see there is a dye lot. So you'll want to make sure to get enough for your project. Now, again, I do want to point out too, you can see here, it is very consistent. It has a little bit of texture. So of course, some bits are just going to be a tiny bit thicker than others, but I did find it very, very consistent throughout, and I didn't come across any knots. And here I have a knit swatch that I worked up in the recommended needle size. These are Knitter's Pride interchangeables. You can see it creates a really gorgeous fabric, again, with a lot of really great drape. And even with the knitting needles, I did not find any splitting when I was working with the yarn. I think that this yarn would be pretty good for both knitter and crocheter beginners. The stitch definition is a little hidden because of the fuzziness of the yarn itself, so it might make it a little bit harder to actually read your stitches in knit or crochet if you're a beginner, but you can see it pretty well. So like I say, if you have a little bit more patience, and you've been crocheting maybe for just a little bit, I think you could definitely go ahead and jump right into using this yarn. Finally, let's take a look at the squish. It has some really good squishiness to it. It doesn't have a whole lot of stretch inside the yarn itself. Because of that core, the yarn itself doesn't stretch much, but it does have a really great feel to it. One pattern that I've crocheted with Patons Norse is this Patons Modern Picots Crochet Cowl, which is a free pattern you'll find on Yarnspirations. I really enjoyed working with this yarn for this pattern, and you can see the two colors really set each other off beautifully, and when you wear it, it squishes down and is oh so cozy. So I think you should give Patons Norse a try today, and don't forget to check out the Cuff to Cuff Cardigan, which is a free pattern in sizes extra small to 5X on mooglyblog.com. Have a great day, everybody!